Hi folks, I'm Rob Hromas. I'm an oncologist, but I'm also Dean of the Long School of Medicine here at UT Health San Antonio. And today I'd like to speak to you briefly about how to virtually interview for medical school. I think these tips will stand you in good stead because I think virtual interviews are here to stay. And we're here to make it easier on you and help you present yourself even better than you thought possible. So we're going to spend about 10 minutes speaking with our Dean of Admissions, Judy-Ann, introduce yourself.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. I think that this is a great service to people out there, the young people trying to follow their path. I'm Dr. Judy-Ann Kellaway. I'm the Associate Dean for Admissions and Outreach at the Long School of Medicine. I'm always delighted to share my advice.
That's true. Judy-Ann is never one short of advice. She's an ophthalmologist by training, still practices, and we're lucky to have
her.
Warm, wonderful individual. Judy-Ann, what are a couple tips that you would give a undergraduate student interviewing for medical school?
I have three for before they get to the interview experience and three for after.
All right.
Number one, make sure your device is up to the task. It needs to be modern enough and it needs to be fully charged and plugged in. Number two, have dependable Wi-Fi. There are ways out there on the web where you have programs that can test your speed, so you should do that. But if you have any doubts about connectivity, you might need to think about using a public library or a room at your institution, if that's allowed. And number three is find out what platform they're using. Download the free version, get familiar with the layout of Zoom and WebEx and all these other things that people are using. Know where your buttons are so you won't be fumbling through the virtual experience.
Great advice.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I think those are important. And then during the interview, we want to make sure your whole face is present, good lighting, no backlit faces. Number two, you want to eliminate distractions. A messy room or a dog barking and barging onto the scene, those are not going to be great for your message. And lastly, I don't think this tip is anywhere. I think this might be the first time you hear this tip. If you are going to hydrate during the virtual experience, use a cup or a glass. If you are drinking from a water bottle, you show us several seconds of your Adam's apple bobbing up and down, and it's just not a great image.
All right.
So,
and don't hydrate so much that you might have to take a break for the restroom.
Yes, that's true, too.
I have a couple of other tips. Dress nicely, but not over nicely. Don't wear a tuxedo or formal gown, but you want to present the best side of yourself.
Yes.
Use your hands, but don't fidget the whole time. I underwent media training when I was a national media spokesperson for the Hematology Society, and they taped me the first time, and I always did this. And in the camera, it looks like I'm choking somebody. So move your hands, but go up and down. Don't go out. And smile, but don't guffaw. Don't laugh hysterically.
Yes.
And look at the camera. Make them feel like they're getting to know you so that they can see your eyes and how bright your eyes are. What are some of the worst mistakes you can make during a virtual interview?
So the worst thing I can think of is that you stand up for some reason and you forget that you have sweatpants or pajama bottoms on.
Okay.
I think you, as you said, you dress for the day, just like we put on our white coats to see our patients, just like we put on scrubs to go to the OR. It gets us in the right mindset. So you should be dressed from top to bottom, and that helps you get in the proper mindset, I think. And I love that you mentioned eye contact. And I would say, make sure that the image of your attention, the speaker or your interviewer, is in close proximity to the whatever camera on whatever device you're using. Make sure that that's where you play with those windows on the different platforms so that you can know how to move things around. I think that helps with the eye contact.
I think eye contact is crucial. Mm-hmm. Don't be too robotic. I think one of the worst mistakes you can make is freeze.
Yes.
And you're just frozen. You can't think of what to say. It's okay to pause a minute.
Yes.
And don't get freaked out by that.
Yes.
Gather your thoughts, take a deep breath, and start again.
Yes.
Everyone would rather you say things accurately than speed off into Wonderland. And don't talk too long. Sometimes people get unused to the virtual format and they can't see the other person's body language, like, okay, I'm done. I want to ask you the next question.
Yes.
and don't be bored. Staring off into space, big mistake.
Yes.
So how are virtual interviews different than a normal person-to-person interview like I'm doing with you?
Yes.
And notice our social distancing.
Yes.
We are more than 6 feet apart, yes. even though we are not wearing masks.
Yes. I think we both have brought up some good points. I think there are a lot of similarities between in-person and virtual interviews, but I think one of the biggest differences is this issue of engagement. And I think this virtual distance in the experience could make it just a little bit harder to connect with your interviewer. So your facial expressions must convey interest and energy. Your comportment, you must comport yourself through the whole day in a professional way. And you, like you mentioned, you shouldn't get complacent thinking in a group presentation, for example. It's the info session, so everybody's together in a big group. You shouldn't become complacent and think you're one of the crowd and slouch and become inattentive. I frequently now in these presentations, I'll flip through screens, all of the gallery views of the attendees, and I'm always very impressed when people are actively engaged. So I would say, if permitted, do all that, be actively engaged, but smile, nod, use the chat and the emoji functions to clap or give a thumbs up and show that you're actively engaged there.
Great point. Virtual interviews are still interactive
yes.
with the chat function
yes.
and some emojis. So you can still take part and but don't be too cute or too clever. Nonetheless,
right.
interact, be pleasant. And if you have something that is add addition to the conversation, please share it.
Yes.
Don't hold back. One of the big differences is you can't read body language well. So you do not know what you are saying, how well it's received by the person interviewing
yes.
you. And one of the big differences is the interviews will be very defined, a defined time and defined questions that they have to ask every interviewee. And so they'll want to run through their questions. So you'll need to give them time to feel like they can ask every question, but enough detail so that they feel like they can write or an evaluation of you.
Yes.
And so provide as detailed answers as possible without taking the whole time. So brief but detailed
yes.
answers.
Yes.
And don't let the lack of body language feedback fool you into thinking that the interviewer is not attentive. This is a big deal for them. This is one of the most important parts of their day or week is evaluating you. And they want you to do well. No interviewer wants the student to do poorly. They're on your side.
That's a very good point and something to remember.
What can someone do to stand out?
This, I think, is the same for the in-person experience and for the virtual experience. And I would say be prepared. You know all the answers. You have your story here in your heart and here in your brain. But when you really should take some time to review, reflect on your experiences, and practice telling your story out loud. And the more you do that, the better you can tell your story in an organized way with some meaning and depth, you know, and enthusiasm, which we might lose when we're practicing. The more interview questions that you can get your hands on and practice out loud, the more confident a person could become, and it presents a clearer message also.
So last question, and I think you touched on it just now. What are some of the most common interview questions for medical school?
Mm-hmm. Tell me about yourself. Tell me why you want to be a doctor. Often we'll refer back to experiences that are in the application, and different interviewers are going to get excited about different experiences. So hopefully a person gets a chance to touch on several different things.
I found that almost all interviews, even for jobs much later in your career, boil down to just 7 or 8 common interview questions. Mm-hmm. Why are you interested in this position? Why here? Why are you applying here? What is your ultimate career goal? What are your strengths and weaknesses? What do you think the most important characteristic of a physician is and why? What's the greatest adverse hurdle you've had to overcome in your life? How did you overcome it? What past experiences have trained you for this position? How would you handle conflict? These are very common questions that many interviewers ask, not just for medical school, but for residency and further along in your career. And if you know good answers to those, I think it will stand you in good stead throughout any interview. And practice the answers and give as much personal insight and stories. They want to get to know you as a person. Tell your story in as detailed but as brief a manner as possible.
Exactly.
Any final thoughts for our potential medical students?
No, just it's a long process and it's a grueling process. So you have to hang in there. You have to stay positive. Stay positive and confident. And I think that those are attributes that'll help you along the road.
Took me 3 years to get into medical school.
Yes.
And yet I still am here as dean. So don't give up. Treat adversity as training, and you will be successful. With that, I'll thank you for your attention, and I hope you all apply to UT Health San Antonio and choose to come here. We have a great family. Thank you very much.